Hello, I'm Ryan of energycreator.com and I made this little windmill that can rotate around this axle with a double bearing system. It has a slip coupling so we can guide the electricity to our battery system. And what's so special about this little windmill? Well, we didn't use a lathe, we didn't use a bench drill, and we didn't use a welding machine. Well, we needed all these machines to build a little windmill, but instead of all these machines, we used Polyeder. So, if you want to know how you build a little windmill without these machines and with just a little bit of Polyeder, well, let's watch the movie. Okay, now let's start building our little windmill. This will be the post of the windmill. And first, we cut off this post, a little piece. It's 3 inch, 7.5 centimeters. Now, these are all the components we're gonna need for this little windmill. Let's see what the components are. Okay, these are the components we're gonna need. Little piece of pipe. It's 3 inch, 7.5 centimeters. The diameter doesn't really matter. These are the bearings. And it comes like this. And later you need a wall. So you need a space like this around the bearing. So the sizes does not really matter. Just look what you have laying around. So a piece of pipe, two end caps, two bearings, a little piece of pipe of metal, two carbon washers, what comes out a grinder or a power drill. These are replacement washers. Well, a little copper coupling for plumbing. The wooden block, we cut off the post. And a broomstick. Well, these are the components we're gonna need. Okay, and now for the materials of the Polyeder. We need some just laminate Polyeder, the cheapest Polyeder you can find. The harder for the Polyeder. A little cup and a piece of wood to stir the Polyeder. We got here some chopped strands. And we're gonna use a little bit of this glass fiber ribbon. Just a little bit, not all of it. So, also a brush. Two gloves to protect yourself and a kitchen scale. Okay, now let's start with a little piece of pipe, the metal pipe and the two bearings. This little piece of pipe is 6 inch, 15 centimeters by half an inch, 1.2 centimeters. Well, it will not fit on this piece of pipe, these bearings. Almost, but it won't fit. So we're gonna sand this little piece of pipe until it fits into the bearing. Let's do that first. Okay, now we have sanded a little piece of pipe, so the bearings fits on here, like this. So now we're gonna put one bearing on 1.5 inch, that's 3.7 centimeters, and these bearings we want 3 inch apart, like here, 3 inch. Now we take a marker and we mark on both sides of these bearings this little piece of pipe. Like that. Now cut these bearings off. Like that. Now get yourself some tape and some paper. Okay, now first we're gonna put some tape on these bearings on both sides to protect the seal of the bearing. That's one. That's two. And now cut away these edges of the tape and the middle with a little knife. Now we have taped the bearings on both sides with tape to protect the seal. Now we take the metal tube and place the bearings on there between the markers. Like this. Now we wanted the bearings 3 inches apart. Like that. So the size in the middle is 2.2 inches, that's 5.5 centimeters. Now we take a piece of paper and we make strokes out of the paper of 2.2 inches, 5.5 centimeters. Make 3 strokes out of this paper. Now we have the 3 strokes of paper. Now get this bearing off and tape 1 stroke here on this piece of pipe. Like this. And now roll up the paper until you don't see the middle ring of this bearing anymore. So the layers of the paper is thicker as the middle ring of the bearing. So let's do that first. Now we have put the paper on a little metal tube like this. Get the other bearing, put it on there, like that. Now take some Vaseline spray and just grease it a little bit in, like that. Now we take the end caps and make holes exactly in the middle of these end caps with the same diameter as this little piece of pipe. Now the holes are in the end caps. Now take the Vaseline spray again and just spray them a little bit in, not too much, like that. Now we also take the little piece of PVC tube of 3 inches, also grease it in on the inside, like that, not too much. Now we take our bearings and our piece of metal tube. And we place this into an end cap, like that. Now we place the PVC tube on there, like so. Now I have here a little piece of bee wax, or candle wax. And now I want to close up this gap on the inside, just temporarily. Just like this. Now I have a block with a hole in it. Now I place it up there, like that. So. Now we are ready to mix some polyether. Now let's mix some polyether to fill up this mold. So, put on your gloves. To protect yourself. Don't forget your glasses. Now we take some polyether to fill up this mold, so it will be 150 grams, that should be enough, more than enough, I think. Now you've got to put 2% of harder into the polyether. A little bit less is also okay, because we have a very large mass here for the polyether. So 2%, that will be 3 grams, so I take 2 grams. Yes, 2 grams. Now, mix the polyether. So, like this. Now we're gonna put some glass fibers, chopped strands, through the polyether to make it stronger. but not too much. Just say 4 grams, 5 grams, yeah, 5 grams, that's enough. Stir it again. Just like this. And now let's fill up this mold. Now the polyether is just like a very thin gel, like this. Now maybe you put the bearing off. Now just pour it gently into the mold. Just like this. Now this bearing, and now fill it up until the mold is full. Just like this. So now the mold is full, you take this little end cap and place it up there, so you know it's exactly in the middle. And now let it harden. Polyether resin hardens by reaction heat. If the mold gets warm, that's normal. If the mold gets very hot, just cool it down in a bucket of water. Now the polyether resin has hardened, get these end caps off. Like this, and get the shape out of the mold. Oh, that's easy. Now this is the polyether shape. Sand away these edges, get the bearings out of here and the metal tube. So let's do that. Now I sanded the edges, let's get these bearings out of here. Just like that. Well, get the paper out and the other bearing. Now it's all greasy. Clean it with some soap and water so the grease is gone. So let's do that. Now we cleaned the shape and the bearings and the metal tube. So let's put the bearings back into the shape of polyether. Just like this. The other one. So nice and tight. And put the metal tube through it. Like that. And now we have a double bearinged system without any friction. So the windmill can rotate on his axle. Very nice. Now let's see how the components of the windmill are coming together. We have the post of the windmill, the little block of the windmill. We cut off the post, comes like this. Now we have the broomstick. You just need a little piece of it. Let's say 40 centimeters. It's 15.7 inch. So cut it off, and then we need a piece of 20 centimeters, that's 7.9 inch. So cut off an extra piece of 7.9 inch, 20 centimeters. So let's do that first. Now we have the two pieces of broomstick, comes like this. And now we cut a hole in the broomstick with the same diameter as the piece of metal tube. Let's say 6 inch, that's 15 centimeters. Now we have cut the hole in the broomstick for the metal tube. This comes here. Now drill a hole through the post, like this, and through the broomstick, like this, very straight, so you can put a screw in it. If you drill the hole for this one, make sure this is, it comes like that. It's parallel to each other. Now we have put the screw into the post to secure the block. Now we're gonna take this component and place it like this. Now let's mix some polyether resin with glass fibers in it. Now I have mixed the polyether resin with glass fibers. I put more glass fibers in it, so it keeps its shape. Now let's do first the corners here. With this polyether resin, secure the block. Of course, just one screw will not hold. Do it nicely all around. Now we have secured the block with polyether. Now let's place this here. So put some polyether on there, like this. And place it up there. Like that, and then just make it nice and tight. The polyether has hardened. Now sand away all the sharp edges. Okay, we sanded the shape, so it's all smooth now. Now we're gonna take a washer that fits around the metal tube like that. And now we take the end cap with the hole again, and we want to place it here to protect the bearing against the rain for later. So we cut it like this. Just a small cap. So cut it away with the saw like this. Place it up here, so it protects the bearing against the rain. Now we can place the broomstick part with the hole on there, but before that we're gonna drill the top hole bigger until halfway. So do that first. Now we have drilled a bigger hole halfway. If you don't have a big drill, just cut out this complete section. So, but before we're gonna place it up here, we're gonna make some grooves here on the sides all around. So let's do that first. Now the grooves are in, let's place this part on there. Maybe you have to use a hammer. So, like that. Now we're gonna mix some polyether again, the glass fiber stuff, and we fill up this gap here, leave this open, and we fixate this piece of wood better. Now it looks like this. Let it harden again. The polyether resin has hardened. We sand it all smooth again. And later we're gonna put a generator on the windmill. So if we have the wire of the generator, it comes later like this. through the metal pipe. But to guide the electricity in such a way the windmill can still move around its axle, we need a slip coupling. And therefore we need a little coupling for plumbing and two carbon washers. So let's make the slip coupling. Let's start with the coupling. You got some markings here. And we don't want that the carbon washer grinds over there. So make a marking like this. And now on halfway. Now cut it here. Saw it through the middle. Now we saw the coupling through the middle, like this. Now we need two electric wires without the insulation. Like this. And then we need some solder for plumbing, some flux fluid, and a gas burner. So let's solder it like this. Now first take the flux fluid, put it a little bit up there, like that. Also a little bit on the ends of the copper wires. Just place it like so. Heat it up. And let it cool. Now the wings are cooled down and I bent this wire a little bit to the middle because we're gonna place the wings like this and they may not touch each other. Let's say the wings are coming 1/4 inch from off each other, that's 1 centimeter, so that will be in total 1.5 inch, 4 centimeters. Now we take some paper and cut off a stroke of 1.5 inch, approximately 4 centimeters, and put tape on it. Now we have a stroke of paper with tape on one side and the wings. They may not touch each other. Now put the tape on the inside and tape it on the wings. Just like that, and roll it up. And secure it with tape again. Like this. Now we take a piece of pipe with the same diameter what we used for the pipe that goes through the bearings. And a little bit of tape and put the tape on there, just like this. Now we take a block and drill a hole in it with the same diameter as this piece of pipe. Now grease it a little bit up, just like that. And what's too much, take it away. Now put this in here. Like that, and place the rings over there, put it exactly in the middle, then we take some beeswax again and we secure it here in the corners, all around. Now the pipe is exactly in the middle. Make sure the wires don't touch each other or the pipe in the middle. So this is okay. Now we mix some polyether with a little bit of glass fibers in it. It's still very thin. And now fill up this little shape. Oh, a little bit too much, doesn't matter. Well, the shape is full, let it harden. Now the polyether has hardened. Get the shape out of the block, somehow. Just like that. Get the beeswax off. Now get the paper off. Now we have this shape. Now get this tube out. Just like that. Now sand away these edges. And maybe sand this with a very fine sanding paper. So let's do that. Now it's all smooth. Let's put it on the windmill. Now the part comes like this. But first, make some grooves again. Now we're gonna use two compound glue to glue this component on here. So let's mix just a little bit of two compound glue. Just a little bit. Mix it. Like that. And now we're gonna use a party stick to put the glue inside of here. Now put the shape on here, so the glue is everywhere now. So, now let it harden. Now the glue has hardened. Now let's take the carbon washers, what comes here like this to guide the electricity. So let's make a little part for the carbon washers. Therefore, we need a piece of wood. It comes like this. Well, we're gonna place a carbon wash like here and like there. Now we have to cut out these holes, these square holes for the washers, like this. And we're gonna do this with a figure saw. Now the square holes are in for the carbon washers, like that. Now let's cut it on size, so cut it off here. We only need this piece. Now we have cut the block on size, also made a little cover plate for it, like this. Now we take the carbon washers. And first, we're gonna solder wires to these carbon washers. Now, don't solder directly the wire to this plate, because this little wire is also soldered to the plate. So, the spring will flip off if you do that. So we take a nail, put it through the spring like this, just like that. Now we're gonna put it into a bend screw like this, push the nail down, secure it, and now we can pull this little cap up. So there's no tension of the spring anymore on this cap. And now you can solder the wire on there. The other one is already on there. So, just like that. And now get the nail out. So, now you got your carbon washers on an electric wire. Okay, now we can put these carbon washers into the block, just like this. Now we take a cover plate, place it up here, and secure it with a screw. Now the part with the carbon washers will come like this, like so. So we're gonna need a piece of broomstick of, let's say, 2 inch. 1 inch and 3/4. So cut off a piece of broomstick of 1 inch and 3/4, that's 4.8 centimeters. Now this little part comes here, so with the broomstick. But we want to make this weatherproof. So we take a bigger end cap, like this. We want to place it here. Over this. So make a big hole here. What fits over the polyeder shape here. Now we have made a big hole in the end cap and a little hole. So the shape will fit like this. And with the little hole we're gonna secure it with a screw into the wood. Now we're gonna mix some polyeder resin again to secure this end cap on the post and the block with carbon washers. Place the piece of broomstick on top of here. Secure it with polyeder resin with glass fibers. So let's do that. Now the polyeder resin has hardened. This is the piece with the carbon washers. It comes here like this. But now the cap is in the way, so cut away a little bit of this material here. So these carbon washers reach their destination. Now we have cut out a little bit of this material. Now let's place these brushes. Just like this. Yeah, perfect. Now mix some polyeder again and secure this here and here. The polyeder is hardened again. Now you got a windmill that can turn around his axle. Now let's take a power connection box and place it here. So let's do that. We have placed the power connection box. And we secured the wire with the tie hip. Okay, our little windmill is almost ready. Now we need a generator for our little windmill. So therefore, I use a little micro generator. And this micro generator is made of polyeder, magnets, copper wire and some PVC. The blades of this micro generator are from a quadrocopter. It's a very expensive toy, but the spare blades are very cheap and they work very good. So let's use this little microgenerator for our windmill. I want to place the microgenerator up here, like this. And we fixate it again with polyether, with glass fibers in it. And if you want to know how to make these microgenerators, or any kind of generator, we got this DVD. Energy Creator, the movie for do-it-yourself generators. So, you can find the information on this DVD and the updates from the DVD how you can make these generators. Now, let's mix some polyether and fixate this generator on the windmill. The polyether has hardened. Now we're gonna put the wire through the metal tube, like this. And we're gonna secure later this wire with tie rips here. Now, cut the wire here, like that. Now get the insulation off. Now the insulation is off. Put it back in the tube. And now let's connect these wires. Now we put the wire through. And first we cut these copper wires on length. And now solder these wires like this. Now we have soldered these wires here. Now let's secure this electric wire with some tie rips. Just like this. Now that's done. Now we take a piece of PVC tube that fits in this end cap. It's 3 inch, 7.5 centimeters. So, comes to there. Cut away some material that it fits in this end cap. We have cut away some material of this little piece of pipe. So it fits very nicely in here, like this. And we're gonna glue it with PVC glue. So, glue it in there. Now we take another end cap with a little hole in it. So the water can get out if there gets water in there. And we glue this end cap also on here. We are almost at the end now. This is the last component we need, a little wooden blade. We place it here like this. So a little piece of wood. I try to clamp it in here. Just like this. So now mix yourself some polyether resin again with chop strands in it and fixate this blade on the windmill. Well, like this. And we have put also some polyether here to close this gap here and here. Okay, now our little windmill is ready to put outside. But before we do that, let's paint the windmill. Okay, now we painted our windmill. Now it's finished. Now we made a little windmill. Without a lathe, without a bench drill, and without a welding machine, and even without this glass fiber ribbon. So, thank you for watching. I'm Ryan of EnergyCreator.com, and maybe you check out my site, EnergyCreator.com, and you can find some more cool stuff you can use for your projects. Well, thanks for watching, and see you later.